We are working with this wooden bike, which is not only a toy, but also a mechanical project. In previous videos, we saw how to create the saddle and its structure, as well as wheels, frame, fork, and handlebar of this bike. The wheels are inserted in this drawing as external references, but the remaining parts of the bicycle are created directly in this drawing. To finalize the wheel, we will open the wheel file to make the changes directly in this external drawing. As a result, the changes will appear in this main drawing as they are inserted as XREF. Let's therefore open the file containing the wheel. We start by drawing a circle, which center is the center of the wheel and has a 2 cm radius. Next, we draw another circle with a radius of 0.5 cm and a third one with a radius of 1 cm. Finally, we need a fourth circle. This time we will use the offset command to draw it parallel with a distance of 0.1 cm. From this circle to the outside. Now let's draw the spokes of this rim. For that, we will draw a line from this quadrant to somewhere inside the wheel. We use offset to create lines with a 1 cm distance on each side. We extend the lines to the first circle. We further draw another line parallel with a distance of 0.5 from the center line on both sides. Next, we select this line and use the grip to move its extremity like this. Let's do the same on the other. Finally, remove the other lines that we used for construction. This will be our ray. But in order to use it as a base for a 3D object, we need to convert it into a single closed polyline. The circles are already closed polylines, but we will need to convert the ray. As you can see, we only have 2 lines here. Let's draw a polyline on top of the lines we have drawn. We now have a closed figure. In our case, it doesn't matter if it is partly inside the circle, at least for what we want to do. To begin with, let's turn off the layer wheel. When viewing the picture from an isometric view, we can better see the actual elevation of the 2D elements we have created. In this case, they are in the XY plane with Z equal to 0, which, if you don't remember from previous videos, coincide with the axis of this wheel. Let's extrude the polyline by a distance equal to or greater than the width of the tyre. We switch to a side view from the right. We change the shading mode to 2D. And we can see here how much it is extending beyond the rim. For the moment, it doesn't matter, as we will cut it later, even if for the moment we have not defined how. So for now, we'll leave it. We return to the isometric view. Now let's extrude the circles that are, as we know, in the center of the wheel. And we will do it like this. The largest circle, we will extrude it with a negative value at least equal or greater than the size of the rim. The following 2 circles, we are going to extrude them with a positive value of 3 drawing units. The smallest circle we will move from the center of this shape to the center of this one. And from this position, we will extrude it with a negative value, with a length even greater than the shape we created before. Now we have here a cylinder, given that by extruding a circle you get a cylinder, assuming of course that the extrusion is straight. And here we have another cylinder. Let's now perform a subtraction between this cylinder and this one. The goal is to generate a hole inside the largest cylinder. We now have a single cylinder, but hollowed. We will see that better if we switch to another shading mode, for example, GOURAUD with edges. We see here the 3D solid object with the hole inside, and inside this hole, the other cylinder. If we come back to the side view from the right, we will now cut the elements we extruded by the central plane. But to begin with, you will remember that this cylinder was extruded backside. Therefore, this face is located in the middle plane of the rim, and we will move it 0.5 units to the left. Let's switch to the 2D shading mode to see the hidden edges. Here you can see better the edges of this shape and what is the axis of the tyre coinciding with the axis of the UCS. Now we use the slice command to cut and remove the remaining parts. We selected these two entities. This other one is not required because it is already ending on the cutting plane. Press Enter. We select this point because we know its position, and a second one following the orthogonal direction to describe our cutting plane. With this axis, we have divided the figure in two, and now we click on the side we want to remove. In our case, here on the right. We switch to an isometric view, change the shading mode, and see the expected result. Now we will give life to the ray of the rim using a similar method. We go to the right side view and change the shading mode to 2D. We use the slice command again to cut this part. But this time, the cutting axis will be indicated by a first point that should match the quadrant of the axis and another one located here in one extremity of the rim. We choose the side that will be removed with a click and, back to an isometric view, we change the display mode and see our ray that looks like one from a modern car. But we still have here a part that should not exist. We will fix that also using slice. Simply write the command and after enter, select the figure, press enter, and indicate the points of the cutting axis. Now let's look at it from the front view and we will replicate our ray around the wheel. We can use the pattern command. In the dialog box, we choose circular. We select the object we want to repeat. Next, we indicate the axis of rotation that will be here in the center and set the number of copies we want, for example 7. Finally, click OK. These rays are independent elements if desired. We could use the Boolean operation union to unite them all together and unite them with the rim. Turn on the layer wheel of the tire and have a look from an isometric view. It looks great, doesn't it? However, rays were created with an angle oriented to one side. If this was the rim of a car, it would be fine, since the procedure is to create the same or very similar. But when it comes to a bicycle wheel, you probably need a wheel looking the same on both sides. Therefore, what we need to do now is to switch to a side view. We need to copy the rays and the axes we have on the one side on the other side, which basically means we will perform a symmetry. We switch off the layer wheel and change the shading mode. Let's use therefore the mirror command. We select the entities and define the axes. Now the rim is the same on both sides. Activate again the layer of the tire. And finally we save the changes. Back to the main drawing, where the wheel was already inserted as an external reference. We see it is already updated with the new design. This is a nice illustration of the 3D features you can find in RS Commander from Graebert.